Thank you for logging on to WPTZ.com. I'm meteorologist Hayley LaPointe with an update on this ice storm that continues across the area. Extremely slippery travel. It's not recommended to head out at all really this morning because overnight we've had some sleet, freezing rain, plain old rain that's actually causing some flooding in some spots really. It's just been a very active weather period overnight and continues on through this morning. We will have this wintry mix lightening up a little bit later, and temperatures are going to rise in many places above freezing, so that's some good news. We'll be able to see things change over to plain old rain, and eventually once the rain even stops, we can begin the cleanup. As for Christmas, it's right around the corner, right? We've got only a couple days to go. Christmas does look good. That's some bright news here to tell you. It'll be cold, but at least we'll have sunny skies and good travel weather for Christmas Eve and Christmas Day itself. Now, here's a look at some of the ice accumulations we've had. Keep in mind that this one in Canton, that was an inch of ice accumulation, this was actually taken almost 24 hours ago. A lot of these readings are old. We haven't gotten many new ones in as of yet. That will probably happen as more of you wake up and report them to us. But it shows you in Canton, about 24 hours ago, there was an inch of ice. So easily there could be double that at this point. In Malone, 0.75 inches. Richford, a half an inch of rain. Same thing in ice, I should say, in Plattsburgh and also in portions of northern Vermont. So it's been nasty the past 24 hours and will continue to be through the morning here. You can see where the dividing line is, where even you have nothing coming down versus where there could be plain old rain, mostly central and southern Vermont into the Northeast Kingdom. It's mainly coming down as rain by St. Johnsbury. But then we have some big differences where the cold air has remained, especially over northern New York. It's been cold enough to change over to some sleet, which is good news, actually, because the sleet is just going to fall. It won't accumulate as much on the power lines, on the tree limbs, too. But it's still making for very slippery travel all along the Route 11 corridor and into the Champlain Valley, the Northway, and I-89, very difficult driving in the northern areas today. We still have an ice storm warning, and that continues until 7 o'clock tonight for this dark purple color, all of northern New York, the Champlain Valley, and right along the Canadian border in northern Vermont. This lighter shade of purple indicates a freezing rain advisory for lesser amounts of freezing rain expected in those areas. The problem is we've had this frontal boundary on top of us, the dividing line between cold air and warm. And in between, right where we are, it's this battle zone per se, and it just can't warm up enough, or it can't get cold enough to get all snow or all rain, vice versa. So we're in between and getting this nasty wintry mix. Futurecast shows you what will happen today. Things will dramatically lighten up as we go into the afternoon, but even by noon, it will still be falling in the form of some freezing rain and sleet in the Champlain Valley before warming up and changing over to all rain later on in the late afternoon and evening. But it will be slippery driving day long with these scattered showers hanging around. As for tomorrow, we're mostly cloudy. There may be a spotty snow flurry or rain shower, but nothing nearly as heavy as what we've had the past 24 hours. And finally, we will clear out by Tuesday, seeing some sunshine. In terms of how much more ice we could get, well, this is about midnight tonight. Some places could tack on another half an inch of ice in northern New York and northern Vermont. So very dangerous driving conditions. We'll be keeping a watch on the power outages, too. Good idea to just hang home if you can today. Slippery mix continues this morning. You'll have a lighter mix by midday, changing over to some scattered rain showers late in the afternoon, but lightening up even more slowly but gradually through the day. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy, temperatures in the mid-30s, above freezing during the day, so we'll get a little bit of melting to happen there. But by midweek, Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, it looks good, but it'll be cold. Look at that temperature on Christmas, only 18. We, of course, will keep you updated here on WPTZ.com. In the meantime, stay safe if you do have to head out, and have a great Sunday.